Hello YouTube. Today I received a new knife. This is the Helle GT36, and it's a mid-sized blade. It is red tang, I think. I'm not sure, but it sticks out here, and I don't really know how far the actual full size tang goes. But first thing I noticed when I held this in my hand is that it's very, very light for this kind of bigger knife. And it's actually pretty nice. Also, it's a very, very beautiful blade. The grip is made of curly birch, and it has some micarta liners, or maybe hardened leather, I don't know, but it has some liners. The blade is laminated stainless steel. Helle doesn't state the kind of steels they use. They only say it's a very special steel, but I believe it's just 12C27, which isn't a bad steel. It's a pretty good steel, and when it's laminated, I believe it will be a lot better even. But I haven't tested this knife yet, so I can't tell yet. But my first impressions are quite nice, quite good. Also, first thing I noticed is that this finger guard is quite sharp. And as you can see, you can see some points where you can really see it. Now this is handmade. It's not a factory knife. I think we should call this a semi-factory knife, because it is mass production, but not like Volkniven. There really is a lot of human skill in this blade, craftsmanship, and I will polish this blade even more when I have the time. But I will take some sandpaper to get rid of this, of these sharp edges, because they're not very they're painful to my head, to my finger, as you can see. It's a sharp edge. In size, this compares to the Bargriffer Aurora. They are about a few millimeters in difference, but what I can tell you is that this Helle knife is a lot lighter. The Bargriffer Aurora is 171 grams, and the Helle is 142 grams, and it might not seem very much, but if you really feel the difference in your hands, it's quite a big difference. And I bet you can still use this knife for small batoning jobs. I won't abuse this knife as hard as I would with this, but yeah, my first impressions overall are quite good. This is not for small hands. The handle is kind of thick. I might use some sandpaper to slink it down a little. But it's a beautiful knife, just to look at. And Well, with my first impressions, I can say that this is probably a very nice knife to take on longer hikes, because it's very light. You won't feel it on your belt, and sorry, I've got some blood on my finger. It's very light, and yeah, I think this is the knife you would take for longer hike trips. For a survival situation, of course, you would want a more sturdy feeling knife like this one, but I don't think this knife will break. You can abuse this knife, I believe. I can even abuse my Mora, so this knife will take a beating. And I think it looks gorgeous. Very nice looking knife. The sheath. The sheath is okay. I think it looks nice. It's a beautiful sheath. It's not very thick. Also makes it very light again. So again, very nice to take on a hike. And yeah, I'm very excited and curious to see what this knife can do in the field. And how it will perform and feel after my own small modifications. And that is positive about these kind of knives. You can really modify them, because curly birch is kind of a soft wood. This is really hard to modify yourself if you don't have the tools and the machines to do it. And this, you just sandpaper it, polish it again, put some oil on it, and it looks gorgeous again. So yeah, this is my small preview of the Hella GT 36. Oh, I forgot to show you the sharpness out of the box, straight out of the box. Might be interesting for some people who are not particularly good at sharpening. It's a very decent sharpness for a factory edge. And the nice thing about Scandinavian knives is that they never, almost never, have a secondary bevel or a micro bevel. Shaves. I think this is one of the more sharper knives you can buy straight from the store. Thank you for watching.